get it, I guess. Hey.
The God complex.
We got the God complex. Good morning, everyone. It is Friday, February 12th. It is a day before my birthday, and we just got blessed with the most pleasant surprise, the best birthday gift that I could possibly get at this time. Right now, Noah and I are gonna drive to our new apartment. So yeah, we're about to pick out the unit and then all the little technical things. And yeah, I'm so excited.
2 hours later.
So I didn't get my place today, but it's fine. It's fine. We're gonna get it on the 20th, but now we're gonna go to the desert. Get it, I guess.
I know this whole song. Are y'all ready? Ready? I'm dead ass right now.
Ready, ready. She got that cute. I thought you were running back and forth. Soccer team.
You're focusing so hard.
And I'm the kid.
I think
her conscience is. She watching an oxygen. I'm watching ESPN.
What smells like lotion?
It's Sex Bomb by Lush. Would you like some?
Oh, Sex Bomb.
Yeah,
get it. What does it do? It makes you horny?
Hi.
It makes guys want to fuck you.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
It's a dick magnet.
I want a dick magnet.
Okay, ready? Brace yourself.
I'm horny now. I want to fuck.
Oh my god, me too.
That's some
shit. No. Like, no one else want to do that.
Okay, I'm doing this. Do that.
I'm just trying to get into a desert.
Ah! Oh my fucker!
I'm sorry.
Why was Pursuit of Happiness playing? Like, where the fuck were you planning on going? Thank you all for coming to my birthday. Today I'm turning 24!
Are you thinking of a good friend?
You maniac!
Back
with
I can't have, but I'm
past
that.
Yeah, go ahead.
Can we get a Crunch Wrap Supreme?
Okay.
And then can I get a number so 7, please?
Sure. What kind of drink?
Just water, please.
Like a bottled water?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, you want to take some of my water? Yeah. Here, take it. Pass it on.
Oh, shit.
Okay, give it to Allie.
Oh, it's so shiny. Get that shit. Here, I got you.
Hurry, hurry. Get loaded. Get loaded. Okay.
Where is it? I handed it. Bitch, you just dropped it. Oh my god.
I'm excited because we're Jupiter.
We're at Mars.
Yes, we're on. We can see all the stars, like, literally.
Josh!
I love Josh.
Are we trendy? We're at Josh's house.
Where's the Joshua tree?
You know what I forgot to tell you, or what I didn't get to tell you? I haven't seen you in so long, but like seeing you again made me happy because like you still look so good. What? Oh, shit. Who put that there? Well, see? I meant that. What are you capturing? What do you want me to say?
We did it!
We did!
All of his stuff is back here. I have no voice. No more FaceTimes.
Nope. I mean, this is real FaceTime. We have actual FaceTime.
Oh.
No, no, I'm a good example. I don't do this.
One, two, one, two, three, let's get it.
Huey hates like making a scene in public, so I decided to take out the vlog.
Yeah, because this is a different scene.
To make it, oh my god, my camera's like fucking broken. Huey hates like this type of attention in public. And like,
I just hate the public.
And like, I don't care. So I just decided to take it out, you know, and make him feel very uncomfortable.
It's not even uncomfortable because we're not doing anything uncomfortable.
Do you want to? Okay, wait, let's walk him through what's been happening for like the past couple of days.
What has been happening in the past couple of days?
Well, that's what they need to know. Nice cock.
Nice cock.
So a little update on like what's been happening for the past couple of days, because like I haven't really got to vlog and like update you guys, but okay, so it's like what, like day four of like living together. How do you feel?
I love it.
He's like, help me, I hate this LA life. This girl, she dragged me to Glendale.
I feel like I'm in a TikTok. Like, forever.
I feel like the culture is a lot different from Stockton.
Hell yeah, I haven't felt like I was gonna die in a minute. It's been a while. Like, I have to get used to the whole, like, I can walk freely without having to, like, look behind me.
What else has been going on? Like, nothing really, because it's fucking Wednesday.
And there's a whole ass Panda Express outside.
Yeah, so we're in like, a whole ass Panera Bread.
You can't even eat bread. I'm sorry.
Okay, let's talk about what we've learned, like, in a long distance relationship. So, like, for me, I've been in, this is like my third long distance relationship that I've been in, and like all the long distance relationships that I've been in have been like significantly different from each other. And then like for Huey, like this is his first one, and like this is like the only one that I've been in where we've actually like overcome the hump of like long distance, and like now we don't ever have to do long distance like ever again. But okay, so let's hear from you. Like, what did you take out of this like long distance experience?
Honestly, the only thing I take away from it is I wouldn't have done this for anybody else other than her. So I knew this was gonna work from the get-go. It was like the only thing that we really had to overcome was me assuring you, because you've had all those other shitty long distance relationships.
Like, going into this relationship, I knew it was gonna be hard, but then like I knew it was gonna be different too. Because like a big thing about like me and Huey's relationship is that like we've actually like known each other before. So let's talk about that.
Let's not
talk about that. No, yeah, I want to talk about it. So like Huey and I, we've actually known each other since like 2009.
12 motherfucking years.
Yeah,
baby.
Yeah, yeah. So we met each other when we were 12. And like now I'm 24 and he's turning 24 in July.
Listen, we've known each other for so long. We've known each other since jerking was a habit. I know y'all motherfuckers know what that is.
And if you don't, then like you're probably too young.
Fucking zoomer.
It's funny because like back in middle school, like Huey actually liked me. But like I didn't really...
She didn't fuck with me at all. Don't even let her do this. Don't let her lie to you. I have been down horrendous.
Cups of the Roses.
I was listening to that song in my room.
Bitches
like...
in my old phone. I should call one and go home.
I've been in this club too long.
So we go way back. There was actually a period of time where like we didn't talk to each other at all.
Because she hurt me so much, like I had to run away.
And like he had to like pull some other bitches out of the grave.
That's really alright.
That's a thumbnail. What I've learned from long distance is that like it only works out with the right people.
Honestly, if I took anything away from this, it's what she used to tell me all the time. Like, if they wanted to, then they will, then they would.
Period.
Who?
Yeah, like dead ass, no, like if they wanted to, then they would. If they really wanted to move in with you, then they would.
And I did.
Like if they really wanted to spend their life with you,
then they would take the actions in order to get there. And like another thing, okay? Like, and this is just like in relationships in general, like never settle. Because the thing that I've learned, because I, like, if you watched my prior videos, then you know that I was in a relationship for like 4 years or something. And I feel like because I was with him for that long amount of time, I kind of just like settled with the thought of like being with him like for the rest of my life, even though like our relationship was so toxic. And that shouldn't have been the case. Like, just because you've been with someone for a long amount of time, like, it doesn't make up for the fact that they're an asshole in your relationship.
If he ain't shit and y'all have years, just leave it. Just leave it. Because I was in the exact same situation. Like, the longest relationship I was in was 4 years, and I thought this was it. Clearly, I had much better options out there, and not even much better. I had the best option out there. I was just waiting for her to come along. If y'all got regrets, if y'all got issues, just let that shit go, because you're eventually gonna be much happier down the line. I promise you that.
Period. Pool.
You already know the vibes.
I think we're gonna switch locations because we're running out of daylight. We gotta chase this motherfucking sun.
And I'm surrounded by too many Armenians.
Shh.
Ow.
All right, so.
It's like the fucking Kardashian family.
Oh my god.
Everywhere. It's like a factory, these motherfuckers. Look.
I'm not Armenian. No.
True. But this is the type of shit that you see in LA. Like, bro, just casually.
Bro, that's just a big ass go-kart. Wait.
Hey. Get the fuck out of here. You want me to hit you with the music video angles?
Jimmy Choo. I choose you. Crystal Dior. You're about to kick my bitch ass out here, and I just got here.
All right, so walk me through your life. This is your home, isn't it? This is your home?
That's not my home. That's my home. Police looking at me?
Yeah.
Man, fuck the police. Fuck the ops, bro. It's not even real police. That shit say traffic control.
Fuck 12.
Yeah.
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 Yeah, fuck 12. Here, like,
she said she's still standing right there.
We're about to age ourselves. Ready?
What are we about to do?
5, 6, 7, 8.
I know we're not doing this shit right. Superman at home now, what are we? You
Thank you guys so much for watching my little week in my life birthday vlog. I am now 24 and Huey now lives here. We conquered long distance and we old as fuck.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Ain't shit to it.
Fuck 12.
Who got the God complex?
We got the God complex.
God complex on me, God complex on 3. 1, 2, 3.
God complex. Woo!
Safe to take a step out, get some air now, let your edge out, to some ice, but you'll be heavy in my-